Here are 10 biology facts about bats and bat Pokemon that you probably didn't know. Or maybe you did, I don't know, that's up to you. Number 1. While flying, Zubat constantly emits ultrasonic waves from its mouth to check its surroundings. I'm sure that basically everyone that has ever heard of a bat knows what this is, but this is called echolocation. Echolocating Pokemon and animals emit these sound waves and then listen for the echoes that bounce back to them. This is how the eyeless Zubat can navigate in its dark caves and how insectivorous bats can find insects flying around at night. Other echolocating animals include toothed whales, some shrews, and even a few different species of cave-dwelling birds. Number 2, Noibat's Pokedex entry talks about how it emits ultrasonic waves at a frequency of 200,000 Hz. Now, most numbers in Pokedex entries are like super hyperbolic, like Magcargo's body temperature being like the temperature of the surface of the sun, but this is one that's actually pretty accurate. The bat species Cleotis percevalli or Percival's trident bat can echolocate using 212,000 Hz sound waves. Number 3, Golbat can drink more than 10 ounces of blood in one sitting. If we relate this to the real vampire bat that only weighs about 1.4 ounces and drinks 1 ounce of blood in 20 minutes, let's see, Golbat would have to, let's do the math here. Yeah, that's a lot of blood it would have to drink. Now, larger organisms do have to consume proportionately less calories than their smaller bodied relatives because their metabolic rate scales differently with the size of the organism. And this is known as Kleiber's Law, and that's a good thing because otherwise at over 5 feet tall and like 120 pounds, Golbat would have to be drinking about 86 pounds of blood each night. So those Tauros better watch out. Number 4, over 500 plant species rely on bats to pollinate their flowers. Some of these are species of mango, banana, and agave, which we use to make tequila. So next time that you're having a margarita or eating like one of your favorite fruits, try and think of the bats. We don't have a nectarivorous bat Pokemon species yet, but I think that would be a sweet addition. And maybe they could even make it like a convergent form on Beautifly or something, except make it a bat Pokemon in the future. Number 5. Golbat's fangs are hollow like straws. Or hollow like some other real life poison types like Proteroglyphus or Selenoglyphus snakes, which include our vipers and our lapids. The way Golbat's Pokedex entry is worded makes it sound like their hollow fangs are the ones that like suck the blood up through their teeth instead of just like ingesting it like you would do if you're eating anything else. But I feel like it would make more sense for them to have hollow fangs in order to facilitate venom delivery like in our aforementioned venomous snakes. Like their hollow fangs are connected to the venom glands in their head so that they can use them like needles to inject the venom into their prey. And this seems like it would make more sense and would explain kind of the poison typing for Golbat. Which leads me to number 6. Lots of our bat-like Pokemon are poison types, and a lot of poison type Pokemon are modeled after poisonous or venomous animals in real life. So are there any venomous bats? If we use the definition of venom by Fry et al., which states that venom is a secretion produced in a specialized gland in one animal and delivered to a target animal through the infliction of a wound, then yes, vampire bats are indeed venomous. And this is because they create an anticoagulant that increases the blood flow of their prey and makes sure that the blood doesn't clot so that they can feed on more blood easier from their victim. And this is a great way to biologically explain the poison typing of the Golbat and Zubat line. Number 7. After feeding, Golbat is known to share its blood meal with others of its kind if they are hungry. This has been documented in real life vampire bats. Bats might preferentially select to share their blood meal with those that they're related to increase their family's chance of surviving and passing on their own genetics. But at least one paper has shown that the best predictor in receiving a blood meal from another bat was how often an individual gave food. So bats that gave food were more likely to receive food if they weren't able to feed in any given night. And that is just so cool, I think this one is my favorite fact. Number 8. Woobat and Swoobat echolocate by emitting ultrasonic waves from their nose. This is in contrast to like Zubat emitting the waves from their mouth. But this does actually occur in real life bats. Bats in the family Phyllostomidae, Hipposideridae, and Rhinolophidae have these large structures around their nose to act as baffling and help focus their ultrasonic waves that they spit out of their nostrils. Which is not unlike the large noses of Woo and Swoobat. Number 9. According to two different Pokedex entries, Noivern is an omnivore. So are there any omnivorous bats? Like, when I think of bat species, I think of like insectivorous bats, vampire bats, and fruit-eating bats. So I wasn't quite sure if there were any omnivores. But it turns out there are omnivorous bats. The greater spear-nosed bat is one of these omnivores that eats vertebrates like mice, birds, and smaller bats, but also feeds on fruit, seeds, nectar, and insects. Oh, and just for fun, there's also bats that like eat fish, and they're incredible. And the big number 10. Did you know that bats are the second largest order of mammals behind rodents with almost 1,400 different species? This equates to almost 20% of all mammal species being some kind of bat. By my estimations, we have about 364 different mammal Pokemon, and we only have about 8 different bat Pokemon, if we include every member of any given evolutionary line. And that'll only make up like 2% of all mammal-like Pokemon. So to hit that 20% mark, we would need like 65 more bat Pokemon to bring those numbers up to make them 20% of all mammal Pokemon. Which is really interesting to think about, like, does the Pokemon diversity reflect the real-life animal diversity in any way? Because apparently for bats, it's not even close. Hopefully this gave you some more appreciation for our bats and bat-like Pokemon, and this is a great way to celebrate October. So thanks for watching, everyone, and stay batty.